All Sports with Dan Malloy.
I'm a hometown hero, baby! Woo! We're Stanley Cup champs, baby!
A day 52 years in the making, baby! Half a million people in downtown St. Louis gathering to celebrate the city's first Stanley Cup championship parade. Not sure what's going to sink in first, the reality of winning the Stanley Cup or the players' hangovers. Since the Blues' 4-1 win in Game 7 Wednesday night, the party has not stopped for the Blues and their dedicated, long-suffering fan base. From Union Station to the Gateway Arch, something like 500,000 in the Blue Note lined Market Street to rejoice at the end of the longest Stanley Cup drought in the National Hockey League. You had new players, old players, drunk players, celebrity fans. Nobody was going to miss this. This was absolutely unthinkable just a few months ago before the Blues finished off one of the most unlikely championship runs in league history.
I love having a good time, and this is the best time I could possibly have. Winning the cup is just incredible with this group of guys, and celebrating with this city who's never won a cup before is just awesome. So I'm having a good time.
I'm so happy for the city and the fans here. They deserve it. But more than anything, I'm so happy for our players because how hard they played, character and leadership coming through, winning us a cup.
It's finally time for the take off the interim tag from head coach Craig Berube. Well, it's been 51 weeks since that play. Arkansas, that close, one out away from its first baseball national championship. The Razorbacks have spent this whole season focused on getting back to Omaha. They think they have unfinished business at the College World Series. And the Hogs threw their ace, right-handed senior Isaiah Campbell, in their CWS opener against Florida State. Third inning, runners on second and third for Matt Goodhart. Looked like he might have had an RBI knock coming, but he lines into a double play. Arkansas 0-for-7 with runners in scoring position. Campbell, electric as ever, ends the fourth inning with a strikeout. 7 shutout innings, 10 Ks for Campbell. Top 9, still scoreless, man on third. FSU's Nander Desaitas flies out to right. J.C. Flowers beats the throw home. That's the game's first run. The guy who scored, Flowers, moves from center field to the mound for the bottom of the ninth. And he goes 1-2-3, striking out Jack Kenley to end it. Hogs lose 1-0. They're going to play Texas Tech in an elimination game Monday afternoon. To the big leagues, the Cardinals going for back-to-back wins on the road in New York. Dexter Fowler had the go-ahead eighth inning bomb last night. He keeps that same energy in his first AB tonight. Solo shot to the same part of the ballpark, 1-0 Redbirds. Michael Wacha did not bring his best stuff to the mound today in Queens. Rookie slugger Pete Alonso takes him deep. A long three-run homer. Mets had 5 runs in the first inning off Wacha. But top 9, one-run game. Colton Wong has the tying run on first. Pop fly into short right field. That's going to drop. It gets by the fielders. Pinch runner Jack Flaherty waved home, but Michael Conforto's throw gets him. And the Mets barely hold on to win 8-7. The Royals battled the Twins tonight. They lost 5-4 on the road. Harrison Bader night tonight at the Springfield Cardinals game. And another promising young center fielder wasted no time getting Springfield on the scoreboard. That's Dylan Carlson. Put one about 420 feet to dead center field. Same inning. Runner on first for Brian O'Keefe. Does this look familiar? Kind of like that Cardinals play in the big leagues. Gets past the center fielder. Johan Mieses coming around all the way from first to score. Springfield goes on to win 6-3 this evening in downtown Springfield. Father's Day weekend means it is U.S. Open weekend on the golf course. Third round of golf's third major today at Pebble Beach. Gary Woodland fired a second round 65 to take a 2-stroke lead into the weekend. Watch the way he just reels in this shot on the par 4 11th to set up a birdie. Just bring that thing back toward the cup. He would kick that birdie in to go to 11 under. That's where he stands as the 54-hole leader. But Justin Rose is right on his heels. He puts down a birdie at 18. He scores a 68 today. One shot behind Gary Woodland. They're the final pairing going into Sunday. Finally, major, major landscape shifting NBA trade tonight. The Lakers acquire Anthony Davis from New Orleans. The 6'10", 26-year-old can really do it all. And getting him cost quite a bit for LeBron and the Lakers. 3 first-round picks, Jesse, plus starters Lonzo Ball, Brandon Ingram, and Josh Hart. That's going to change everything with the draft next week, free agency the week after that. It got real interesting tonight.
Really did. That trademark unibrow headed to Hollywood.
Yes,
now.
It is.
So, and I know, funniest thing about this whole thing to me was that Lonzo's dad put the hex on the Lakers, say they'll never win a championship again. So we'll see about that.
LaVar Ball going down to Bourbon Street. That could be fun.
Definitely is. Dan, thanks. We'll be right back with a final look at your forecast for Father's Day.